Hey guys, in this week's video, we're talking about prostate cancer, a really important condition that we need to raise awareness on. We're going to talk about the symptoms that everyone needs to be aware of and when to seek medical attention. Now, please do bear in mind, if you have any of the symptoms or signs that I discuss in this video, it doesn't automatically mean that you have prostate cancer. It could be due to various other things that are causing it. However, the most important take-home message is, if you have any of these signs or symptoms, please, 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 speak to a healthcare professional as soon as possible. Now, I appreciate this is going to be quite a long video, so if at any point you want to find any specific information, the video is chaptered, it's all in the description below, feel free to click it, find the relevant chapter that you want to find more information on, and click it. However, I would strongly advise that you watch the entire video so that you learn everything you need to know. So to begin with, what is prostate cancer? Let's first start with cancer. So cancer is a disease where genetic changes can cause a cell or multiple cells to grow abnormally, and this abnormal growth can then result in a tumor. And the way that these cells change in a tumor can affect body functions such as your immune system, your blood, your hormones, and then they can cause other problems. So prostate cancer is a particular type of cancer that starts within the prostate. Now, the prostate is a walnut-sized gland and it's found just below the bladder. Prostate cancer is the most common type of cancer in men, accounting for about 26% of all new cases. Now, prostate cancer is more common in older individuals. About 35% of cases are in those who are 75 and over. However, a quarter of all cases are found in patients who are under the age of 65, which again is why it's so important that you know the signs and symptoms to be aware of. Now, prostate cancer is more common in those with black ethnicity. It's also more common in those who are overweight and obese, or if you have a family history of prostate cancer. Now, the bad news is that no one really knows the actual reason why prostate cancer happens, but the good news is that early diagnosis of prostate cancer means that it can be treatable and curable. In fact, up to 84% of men with a prostate cancer diagnosis survive for more than 10 years. And this is again why it's so important that you're aware of the signs and symptoms to look out for and when to seek medical attention. Also, remember, other people might be having these signs and symptoms, and by you being aware, you can really help out and make a difference. Early catching of cancer or prostate cancer can make a massive difference in survival rates and quality of life, which is why it's super important that we're doing this video and raising the awareness on these signs and symptoms. So what are the signs and symptoms of prostate cancer? Well, the initial signs and symptoms of prostate cancer are very rare. It's very rare to actually have symptoms at the start of prostate cancer. That's because it usually takes quite a long time for the prostate to grow and cause any signs or symptoms. So you may have had it for a long time before you actually start to feel any symptoms. And symptoms only usually get noticed when the prostate grows large enough to then press on something called your urethra. Your urethra is the tube that carries the urine out of your body. So what I've done is I found a makeshift urethra. This is actually from a blood pressure cuff. So if you imagine this is your urethra and your urine comes out at the end, this is going to be our prostate. So it goes through it like that. And eventually, once the prostate then grows, it's gonna press on this urethra. And by pressing on the urethra, we're gonna get the symptoms that we're gonna talk about. So when this happens, there's some signs that you need to be aware of. So for example, the main thing is having any difficulty peeing. So for example, this pressure is gonna cause us to struggle to pee. We're also gonna have a lower flow. We're gonna have a difficulty starting as well to actually pee. And also, because of this pressure, you might feel like you haven't emptied enough. You haven't emptied of urine, or you might feel like you've still got some left as well. So these are common symptoms caused by this pressure on the urethra. You may also find that you need to pee a lot more often than you used to, and you might be waking up at the night multiple times during the night to go and pee. You might also get sudden urges that you need to pee really badly. These are things that you obviously haven't experienced before and are suddenly coming up. Also, you might find that you're dribbling a lot more after you've peed. So once you finish, you find that you're still dribbling, or you might even find that you have a bit of incontinence or a bit of leakage when you're going to the toilet. Now, at this point, please do not panic. It does not mean that you automatically have cancer, but again, the most important thing is if you have any of these sort of symptoms, if you notice any of these kinds of symptoms, or you know someone who is, go and speak to your healthcare professional. It could just be an enlarged prostate, okay? It could be something else that's causing it, but the most important thing is that you speak to a healthcare professional so they can do the relevant investigations that are required. And as I mentioned earlier, one of the reasons why it's so important you're aware of these is an early diagnosis can massively increase survival rates as well as increasing the quality of life. Hopefully it's not cancer, hopefully it's something else, but you just need to be aware of it and it needs to be checked out. Now, sometimes prostate cancer can eventually spread to other body parts as well. Remember how we discussed cancer at the start of the video, discussing how it can affect other parts of the body as well. This can sometimes happen as well with time with prostate cancer, known as advanced prostate cancer. One of the main symptoms to look out for this is any sort of dull, stabbing, aching pain within your bones, such as your back, your pelvis, and your hips. And another few points for you to be aware of is any swelling in the legs, any blood in your wee, so if there's any change in colour, any blood in your semen, so again, if there's any change in colour, if it's a brownie colour or any change in colour, speak to your healthcare professional. If you're having any difficulty getting an erection or keeping an erection, and also, if you're feeling generally unwell and tired all the time, and lastly, if you're having any weight loss, so unexpected weight loss, stuff that you didn't plan, you just feel like your clothes are feeling a lot looser all of a sudden and you haven't been dieting and you've had unexpected weight loss. Now, these are just a few symptoms of advanced prostate cancer, because it really depends where it's spread to as well. There are many other symptoms as well, which I will leave in the description below. So if you want to find out more information on them, please give it a read. And the most important point to remember from these signs and symptoms, if you're having any of these, so the symptoms of prostate cancer that we spoke about earlier, and also the symptoms of advanced prostate cancer that we just spoke about, please, please, please speak to your healthcare professional. Don't wait. Don't wait a few weeks and think it's gonna get okay. Speak to your healthcare professional there and then. And if you know anyone that's got these symptoms, tell them to speak to their healthcare professional as well. So now that we know about signs and symptoms, let's talk about diagnosis, because you might be wondering, well, what's my healthcare professional gonna do? Now, there's no simple test for prostate cancer. Your healthcare professional will do multiple investigations. For example, they might do a urine test to check for any infection. They might do a prostate exam. They might do a prostate biopsy. They might also do a blood test. They might do an MRI. So there's multiple tests that they will do. So one of the most common blood tests that we do here in practice is the PSA blood test. We're gonna measure the amount of PSA within your blood. PSA stands for prostate specific antigen. A high amount doesn't necessarily mean prostate cancer, because 15% of patients with prostate cancer sometimes have a normal or low PSA level, but it's a really good indicator along with all the other tests that your healthcare professional is going to do. Now, PSA testing can be really helpful in finding both aggressive types of prostate cancer as well as slow growing prostate cancers. But because of its issue of reliability, it's not often used for routine health screening here in the UK. Now, here in the UK, we also offer something called the Informed Choice Program for PSA blood tests. This means that any male over the age of 50 can have a PSA test from their GP surgery. Now, if you've got symptoms, then definitely speak to your healthcare professional and they're going to do that anyway. But even if you don't have symptoms and you're perfectly fit and healthy and you want a PSA blood test, they will do it for you as well. So please bear that in mind as well. Now, early PSA testing can be particularly beneficial for those who are especially at a higher risk of prostate cancer, like we spoke about earlier. So for example, those who are of black ethnic origin, those who are overweight, those who are obese, or if they have a family history of prostate cancer. So remember, you don't have to wait until you have symptoms. If you are 50 and above, then you can go to your GP surgery and get a PSA blood test. But remember those signs and symptoms. If you have any of them, speak to your healthcare professional. In different countries, they do things differently. I think in America, they do PSA blood tests every 1 or 2 years for certain men. But like I say, I'm talking about the UK here. I don't know the rules for other countries. Speak to your healthcare professional over there for more advice on this. And of course, I will leave loads more information about PSA blood testing in the description below. The NHS has a useful link on it as well, so if you want more information, feel free to click on the description and click on that link to find out more. So please do remember, if you have any of the signs and symptoms of prostate cancer that we spoke about in this video, there's gonna be a box here that pops up as well, feel free to pause it. Please, please, please speak to your healthcare professional. That is the most important thing, because your health is the most important thing. And remember, Catching prostate cancer early can have a significant impact on survival rates and your quality of life, and actually treating it as well. So please remember these signs and symptoms. You now know them. If you know someone else that's suffering from these signs and symptoms as well, point them in the right direction. And as always, I will leave loads more information in the description below. And please remember, just by having these signs and symptoms, it doesn't automatically mean that you have prostate cancer, but it's just important for you to remember these. I will leave loads more information in the description below for you. So that's it for this week's video. I really hope you found this information helpful. This is a topic that we need to raise more and more awareness of. Prostate cancer is a real big thing now. It's the most common cancer for men, and we need more men to be aware of these signs and symptoms. It's a difficult thing to talk about, but I really hope that you found this information helpful, and now you know what to look out for. You know what to look out for yourself, you know what to look out for your friends and family as well. As I always say at the end of the video, always remember that you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.